Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the SEED Technology Research Lab for the on-campus training program under which we are here in the SEED Technology Research Laboratory. And in this laboratory, the history behind this laboratory is this is under the All India Coordinated Research Project of ICR, and this project is running under this department since 1980. Earlier it was known, this center was known for seed-borne disease, and later on it was merged with the National Seed Project, and it is now under the National Seed Project Seed Technology Research of the various crops. So, looking to the topic, we will learn today under this topic will be detection of seed-borne pathogens. So, seed-borne pathogens directly going to the testing and testing methods, these all comes under the science of seed pathology. And seed pathology and the seed health. So, I would like to give you some introductory part so you can will be benefited. So, if we talk about the seed health or seed health testing, the objective behind this is to determine the health status of a seed sample and by inference that of the seed lot. Health testing of seed is important for four reasons. First one is the seed-borne inoculum may give rise to progressive disease development in the field and reduce the commercial value of the crop. Second is imported seed lots may introduce disease into new regions. Tests to meet quarantine requirements may therefore be necessary. Third one is the seed health testing may elucidate seedling evaluation and causes of poor germination or field establishment and thus supplement seed germination testing. Fourth one is seed health test results can or may indicate the necessity to carry out or to perform seed lot treatment in order to eradicate seed-borne pathogens or to reduce the risk of disease transmission. Now looking to some definitions related to this is, first of all, seed health. Health of seed refers primarily to the presence or absence of disease-causing organisms, such as fungi, bacteria, viruses, and animal pest, including nematodes and insects. But physiological conditions such as stress element deficiency may be involved. That is called as seed health. Then pre-treatment, any physical or chemical laboratory treatment of the working sample preceding incubation given solely to facilitate testing, that is called as pre-treatment. Then seed treatment, for seed health testing, a seed lot may be treated for the purpose of controlling plant pathogens or insect pest or correcting the stress element deficiencies. That is called as seed treatment. ISTA, that is ISTA, it is a International Seed Testing Association. ISTA Seed Health Method Validation Program under which before publication in the International Rules of Seed Testing, the ISTA seed health testing methods are validated. So the validation is required to be submitted into the or before published into the ISTA rules. The principles and factors which should be considered in the validation of methods for the detection of seed-borne pathogens are described in the ISTA Handbook of Method Validation for the Detection of Seed-borne Pathogens. So if we talk about the general principles of seed health, the testing should be performed using seed health testing should be performed using methods and equipments which have been tested to ensure they are fit for purpose. Different methods of testing are available, varying in sensitivity and reproducibility, and in the amount of training and equipment required. The method used will depend on the pathogen or the condition to be investigated, the species of the seed, and the purpose of the test. Selection of the method and evaluation of the results requires knowledge and experience of the methods available. The presence or absence of disease organisms, pest, and deleterious physiological conditions specified by the sender is estimated as accurately as the method used permits. Then seed health testing methods. There are several seed health testing methods available and have been evolved for fungal, bacterial, viral and nematode pathogens. While selecting a method, it is necessary to consider that it is reliable, less time consuming in obtaining the results, economical, reproducible and sensitive. Now detection procedures have already been entered in the molecular level now. However, majority of the pathogens can be detected by simple methods. But before going to into details of seed testing methods, I will give you some introductory part which is of very important, that is regarding the our father of seed pathology, that is Dr. Paul Nirgaard. He is the father of seed pathology science. Now, as we know, seed is a basic input in the crop production. So seed, it is called as a horse of hunger or source of life, because actually, as we know, the crop or the seed or the grains we produce in the farm, that will be the food source for all livings on the earth. So it is a basic unit or the source of life, we can say, without which we cannot survive. So Paul Nirgaard contributed during the 1907 to 1987 in the science of seed pathology. Nirgaard served as director of Danish Government Institute of Seed Pathology for developing countries in Copenhagen, Denmark, that is in Denmark. From 1956 to 1974, he served as the chairman of Plant Disease Committee of the International Seed Testing Association, that is ISTA, ISTA. During his tenure as chair of ISTA, he helped to standardize methods for detection of seed-borne fungi. Nirgaard authored a 2-volume textbook entitled Seed Pathology. So volume 1 and 2 of seed pathology, it is also available in our library. Now coming to the seed health testing methods, it is categorized in the 3 important categories. So when we get the seed sample, we should first examine as a ungerminated seed. Direct, so we can directly examine the seed lot or seed sample. That can be performed by naked eye or the visual inspection of the observation. So through naked eye, we can observe the smut balls or gut of bajra, cockles or galls of the wheat. By using stereo binocular microscope for seed discoloration and morphological abnormalities, the fungal structures on the seed coat, the pycnidial bodies on the cowpea seed surface, we can observe easily by the aid of stereo binocular. Then seed soaking is also required to visualize easily and perfectly. So the soaking is done by water and using chemical. By using water, we can easily observe the ooze of pycnidiospore in cowpea seed under the microscope. By using chemical like sodium hydroxide, NaOH 0.2%, we can easily visualize the kernel bunt of wheat. So kernel bunt infection in the wheat seed can be visualized easily by using this chemical treatment, seed soaking. Seed washing examination for spores of downy mildew of bajra. So that we should wash, seed wash, we can examine and confirm for the presence of spores. So that we can, that by that way we can say that if this sort of lot have spores, then there may be chances of the infection of downy mildew of bajra. Then whole embryo count method. This is a specific method used particularly to detect the loose smut of wheat infected embryos having blue stain mycelium. Embryos with blue stain mycelium will produce loose smut of wheat in that plant. So it is an internally seed-borne pathogen. Now second category is examination of germinated seed. After germination, we can observe for seed detection. In that, incubation methods are performed. In that, standard blotter method and agar plate method are these two methods which are routinely used in the as incubation methods in the seed pathology laboratories. Under the standard blotter method, there are two modifications. One is using 0.1 to 0.2% 2,4-D solution blotter soaking. And second modification is the deep freezing blotter method, that is at -20°C. And second method of incubation is agar plate method. In that, pre-treatment with NaOCl, sodium hypochlorite, 1% solution for 5 minutes is given as a pre-treatment. Second stage is the seedling symptom test. Under seedling symptom test, seed sowing in autoclaved soil, gravel and sand. This way also it can be performed. Then by in vitro, by using the wide mouth test tube agar method can be performed by using 1 to 1.5% agar. In that, 16 mm diameter tube is used, and in that 10 ml of agar per tube is poured, and per tube one seed is plated or one seed is put into the center of the tube. Then it will be covered with the aluminum foil. Then it will go for incubation at 20°C under artificial daylight, 12 hours light and 12 hours dark cycle. By using this technique, we can observe easily the symptoms of Xanthomonas campestris in the cabbage and cruciver crops seed. Likewise, in the fungi like Drosera, Septoria, Fusarium in wheat, oat and barley. Then, using bioassay, in that indicator plant test is performed. So, indicator plants of the host can be, by using this plant, we can test the presence of the pathogen. By using the serological methods like ELISA, we can detect the viruses like seed-borne viruses like BCMV embryo, BCMV embryo in 1 of 2000 and Lettuce mosaic virus in 1 of 1400 seeds can be detected. So this is a kind of the precise and precision of the this test, ELISA test, which is a well-known test as an enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. Then third category under this detection method is examination of plants beyond the seedling stage. So under that, GOT, that is growing on test, is performed. And this test is performed for the systemic infection of fungi and the bacteria like Xanthomonas and Erewinia. So these are the main seedling seed health testing method which can be performed in a three category type, but the visual observations or the seed as such also should be tested or observed before going further. So this seed health testing methods for fungi under visual examination with or without stereo microscope we can perform and inspected in dry state for the presence of impurities such as ergots and sclerotia. Under this seed discoloration in case of soybean seed, if it is discolored with the black color or the seed coat is black, you can easily say as it is infected with the soybean mosaic virus, SMB. If it is having the purple stain on the seed coat, then it is caused by the Cercospora blight. The pathogen fungus is Cercospora kikuchi. It is caused by Cercospora kikuchi. So purple stain and black stain, the kind of differentiation you can make by visual observation directly from the seed sample. In case of lentil seed, discoloration caused by Ascochyta blight, you can see. Then field pea, seed infected with pea seed-borne mosaic virus, there is a kind of combinations of the variation discoloration you will find. Then morphological abnormality in case of healthy wheat seed compared to the shriveled wheat grains and plump healthy seeds. So compared to the healthy, you can differentiate between the abnormality caused. Then healthy barley grain compared to the shriveled grains from the disease crop in case of barley. Then sclerotia of ergot sclerotia, seed gall nematode caused by the wheat, seed gall nematode or the ear cockle of wheat as a mixture in the seed. You can easily identify by the visual observation or as a physical purity. Then sorghum ergot, then contamination of permillet seed with the ergot infested ones, and in case of potato black scarf, as a crust, soil crust as admixture, we can easily observe by visually. Then black powder mass of the burnt spore in case of burnt of wheat, we can also see under the visually or the under the microscope both way. So visually you can find the infected seed with a black powder mass compared to healthy one. And you will also find the different categories of infection in the wheat seed and along with the types of the spores causing the infection. And you can see also the photograph of the germinating smutter spore or the bunt spore from the elongating basidium. And the terminal hole of the primary basidia spore in the germinating tilia spores. Then you can see the galls on the wheat, and you can compare the galls with the healthy seed, how the whole seed is converted into the galls, nematode galls, and you can also see the nematode larvae causing the causal agent of the wheat gall, that is Anginia tritici. Now, as I told you, under the incubation methods, there are two routine laboratory methods which is followed in every seed testing laboratory, that is standard blotter method and the PDA plate method or the agar plate method. Standard blotter method, in that the blotter papers are used, whereas in the PDA plate method you require the media, that is potato dextrose agar PDA. So that is the main difference of the substrate, we can say. Now, under the standard blotter method, we required the materials like a plastic battery disc that should be transparent, then blotter paper, distilled sterile water, forceps, trays, glass side, cover slips, like that. Then chamber and equipments required. First, we required the inoculation chamber, incubation chamber with the NUV fitted racks, laminar airflow, autoclave, oven, stereoscopic microscope, compound microscope. So this is the material we should require first to perform this test. Now the method is like this. First of all, we should sterilize the plastic petri plates using 1% formalin solution in which the plates are soaked and the plates for 10 minutes and take out from the solution and keep it for air drying. Then next step is cut the blotter according to the diameter of the plate, that is 90 mm plate are used generally, and using the scissor and sterilize in the autoclave. Keep the sterilized plastic plates and keep the sterilized plastic plates and sterilized blotters on the clean and sterilized working surface of the laminar airflow. The next step is take sterilized blotters and prepare sets of 3 blotters for each plate. Disinfect forceps tip by flaming for few seconds and cool it. Next step is, with the help of forceps, dip one set of the blotter paper in distilled sterile water, and after complete soaking, lift the set and allow the extra water to run off. Then likewise, the first prepare all the plates in the same way, then wipe off and dry the laminar flow working surface. Now we have to place the seed with the help of sterilized forceps on the moist blotter surface. Number of seeds per plate depends on the size of the seed, that may be 5, 10, 20, 25 per plate. For plating 25 seeds, keep one seed in the center, each seed in the middle circle, and 16 in the outer circle. whereas for 10 seeds, 1 seed plated in the center and 9 seed in the outer circle. Then you have to place the counted seed at equidistance. Equidistance means equal distance all seed you have to plate in a circular fashion. Then make the plate, mark the plate, not make the plate, mark the plate like date, time, number of sample, crop, variety, location. Then collect the plates in the tray without disturbing the seeds. Now you have to incubate the plates in the incubation chamber at 20 to 25 degrees centigrade for 7 days, having 2 NUE wavelength, NUE of wavelength 320 to 400 nanometer tubes fitted on the rack horizontally and 20 centimeter apart, and the distance between the tubes and the plates should be 40 centimeter in the way of alternate cycles of 12 hours dark and 12 hours light. So after 7 days of incubation, seeds are examined one by one under the stereoscopic binocular microscope. Then associated microflora identified based on the morphological characters. These are also confirmed by preparing and examining their slides under the compound microscope. And then count the number of fungi observed on the seeds and record it. So this is the whole procedure of this plotter plate method. Now advantage of this method is, plotter method is the most convenient, cheap and efficient method. The method was first adopted by Dwyer in 1938. A large number of mycophora, including Alternaria solani, Stemphylium solani, Colitotrichum dimacium, Colitotrichum lindemuthium, Macrophomina pagellina, Fusarium oxysporum, etc. can be detected by this test. Then, as I told you earlier, there are two modifications with this method, standard blotter method. And first one is the modified standard blotter method. So here only difference is the blotters are moist with 2,4-D at the rate 0.1 to 0.2% solution. And rest of the method is remain same as per the standard blotter method. So advantage of this method is the sodium salt of 2,4-D retard the seed germination and seedling growth, and hence the seeds are not displaced and remain undisturbed where they were plated, and the seed examination is made easy. So this is benefit or advantage with this modification. Second modification is like deep freezing blotter method. Here the seeds are plated as in blotter method, but in incubation, first it is incubated initially for 24 hours in the incubation chamber. Then these plates are transferred to deep freezer in minus 20 degrees centigrade for 24 hours, means one day. Then the plates are transferred to incubation chamber for remaining 5 days. So this way this test is performed. An advantage with this method is, or modification is, low temperature kills the seed matter. This provides the nutrients for better development of associated mycophora. So by giving this deep freezing treatment, seed matter is killed, and so better developed mycophora we can see easily after the incubation under the observation. So how seeds are plated. You can see in the pictures, by pictures also, in the standard blotter method, and then after 7 days incubation, you will find the microflora with the seeds like this. So first, as I told you, the all materials should be with the laminar flow surface with you, handy. And after taking the observations, you can will find the microflora like this. The figure shows the detection of Drosselera oryzae in Oryza sativa rice seed. You can see the seedling in the blotter test lesions on the coleoptile and the conidia, which are responsible, the fungal conidia responsible for the these symptoms, seedling symptoms, that is conidia of Drosselera oryzae. Again, the conidia force and conidia on the rice seed you can see easily under the high magnification. You can able to see this conidia force and conidia like this. Then in the detection of Pyricularia oryzae again rice seed, you will be able to see the growth of this organism Pyricularia on the rice glooms. You can see the conidia force and conidia, but the close up view, you will find the conidia force and conidia like this. Then fungal structures like in case of anthracnose caused by Colitotrichum demesium of groundnut, a wedge shaped lesions on the leaflet you can find, and the fungal growth on the seeds. Then acerulae with the city on the seed and conidia, you can find the structures of the fungus. Then another is the charcoal rot caused by Rhizoctonia betaticola of groundnut. A water soaked necrotic lesions on the pods, infected cotyledons, infected seed with sclerotia alone, then pycnidia and conidia ooze on seed, and then pycnidia, conidial ooze, and conidia of Macrophomina fasciolina. So this type of structure can be visualized while under the observation under the stereobino and with the compound microscope. Now, as I told you, another routine method is the PDA plate method or agar plate method. It is so here the material required will be the glassware, petri plates, beakers, measuring cylinders, funnels, conical flasks made of glass. Then media like potato dextrose agar, PDA, or the nutrient agar, NA for the bacterial infection to be detected, NA is used. Then you require distilled water. Then equipments like oven, autoclave, inoculation chamber with the laminar airflow system, and incubation chamber. Now method is like this. First of all, you have to prepare potato dextrose agar medium PDA. In that, peeled potato slices 200 gram, boiled in 700 ml of water. Agar powder 20 grams dissolved in 300 ml water with 20 gram dextrose. And final mixing and making up volume up to 1000 ml, that is 1 liter. Then you have to sterilize the media in autoclave at 121.6 degree for 20 minutes at 15 lb pressure, 15 pound pressure. After semi-cooling, pour the melted medium in sterilized petri plates, about 15 to 20 ml of medium under the aseptic conditions in the laminar airflow. After solidification of medium, invert the plates for 12 hours. and discard the contaminator plates. Place 10 surface sterilized seeds that is treat with sodium hypochlorite NaOCl 1% for 5 minutes and plating immediately without washing the treated seeds, and it is an internationally accepted procedure on the media under aseptic condition. Likewise, you have to plate the 10 seeds, one in the center and 9 in the circle, outer circle. Incubate the plates in incubation chamber for 7 days and then it will go for examination. Examine the seed for developing associated microflora by naked eye based on colonic color and stereoscopic binocular microscope on the basis of habitat characters. Now, advantages of this method is, this method is most suitable for the detection of internally seed-borne fungi. For example, species of Ascochyta, Macrophomina, Phoma, it is very well used. Muscat and Colhoun in 1941 first used the method. Now you can see the PDA plates, how it is prepared. After pouring the 15 to 20 ml of PDA, you have to pour in each plate. Then you will find the microflora developed on the seed PDA plates. In the colonies way of the various color, you can find after the incubation period of 7 days. Then detection of Alternaria, Linicola and Botrytis cinerea and Colitotergum linin, linium, flaxseed. So you can here see the colony color or the morphology of the colony of the olive gray colonies of Alternaria linicola and darker colonies of saprophytic Alternaria, saprophytic or darker colony. And the conidia of Alternaria linicola, you can see the photograph of the conidia which are responsible, or which we can say the seed of the fungi. Then the colonies of Botrytis cinerea spreading from the diseased flax seed on the malt extract agar after 9 days of incubation, and you can see the sclerotia, it is visible on the in the right plate. And you can see in the another photograph the Conidia force and Conidia Botrytis cinerea, the close-up view and the tape-like mycelium. So this is all about the detection methods for seed-borne pathogens which are routinely used in the laboratory. And as I told you, before that you should perform first the physical purity test. In case of seed pathology, we are concerned with the seed discoloration and the abnormality with the seeds. So that should be taken care as a prime requirement. Then if you required, you can go for these methods, various kinds of methods. Now coming to the your another topic for which I have to take care. Recording the observations in the field experiment and calculation. So after test, when you are going for your PG research, this is required to know how the test or the research in the laboratory or the field condition should be performed. So it should be matched with the statistical analysis and the design. For generally complete randomized design, CRD, is used in the laboratory where the experimental material is homogeneous and it is under the control conditions. So here you will have to finalize the treatments, the repetitions, and the randomization you can make. Then it is also followed by CRD factorial, like 2 factors, 3 factors, means if you have cultivars, you have to take the observation on seed germination, the vigor index, you have to perform or use this type of design, that is CRD factorial. Now, in case of you have to take your research problem in the field, it will go as another design, or you have to use another design, that is randomized block design, RBD, it is said. So here, in this design is performed, and when the experimental material is heterogeneous and the fertility variation will be there, and to minimize the error and variations, we should perform the test like using the design like RBD. And here in this, there will be various treatments having reapplications and randomizations will be there. Here the word replication and repetition, in CRD it is called as repetitions, for RBD it is replications, it is replicated trial in the field. So here we have to keep in mind while selecting or finalizing the treatments and replication, there should be minimum degree of freedom 12 degree of freedom minimum should be there. So you should accordingly to finalize the number of treatments and the replications. So for example, if you have 5 treatments, then there should be 4 replications. So that will you. So while you are subtracting -1 from each, you will be able to get more than the required degree of freedom, or the 12 degree of freedom. So you should have to fix the plot size according to the crop and number of plants you required, but the prime requirement will be your plots length and width should be fixed, like it should be in a rectangular mode. Then according to the crop spacing, it will also affect your plot size. So matching with this, you have to finalize the plot size. Then coming to then it will be followed by the seed treatment or the spray schedule, whatever you are going to utilize for that particular research program. But generally the 500 liter of per hectare volume or the solution should be sprayed in a 1 hectare crop. So I have taken the example of the management of Tikka disease of groundnut through the various fungicides, and groundnut variety I have taken is GG20 with 5 different fungicides, one of which I can tell you, tebuconazole 50% plus trifloxi strobin 25% WG, and concentration will be 0.05%.
तू आ तो रखे तो सीढ़े मुके तो देखा तुम नहीं पासू जरा भाई सीट मुक है भाई खसाड़ा ही नहीं आ रहा मेरी इतना घर वाला स्पिरिट ले मगर पहले प्लेट पाचा प्लेट आकर के नीता राजू थोड़ी बात મતલબ આ પ્રોટો પ્લેટ ઉપરથી ઢાંકણો બતાવી દે, વાંધો નહીં. Ready? Hold on.
Here you can see the stereoscopic microphotograph of a seed-borne microflora. This is the seed of chili, and here you can see the chytomium fungal growth on all over the chili seeds, showing yellow pigmentation also. Also, this is the Aspergillus flavus showing sporangia. These all are the mass of the spores of Aspergillus flavus. This is also similar kind in a growing stage on the chili seeds. As you can see here, this is the Aspergillus niger. Here you can see the clear structure. There's sporangia and all the spores here on the chili seeds. In this clip, the seed is totally covered by all the saprophytic fungi. This one is Fusarium being, and these all other saprophytic fungal growth. In this slide, you can see, in this clip, you can see the growth of the Fusarium fungi on the seed as well, this side. This is the mixture of Rhizopus plus Fusarium on the same seed, and here you can see the mycelial structures on the germinated seed also.